Hey guys, I am live a little bit earlier today, and it's because I wanted to get my dinner prepped now, and rather than try and record it and show it to you guys later on, I figure I would do it now. Then I'm going to come back on later on this afternoon when I actually put everything together. And the reason is I use my stack cooker for this, and I wanted to make sure you guys were a part of this whole process of when I brown my ground beef. And I've posted videos about this before, but I figure since I'm doing it this way, I'll share with you guys. And hi, Laura. I figure maybe some of you guys are on lunch break or something. Hi, Eva. So I put about, I would say, roughly 2.5 to 3 pounds of ground beef in my stack cooker. And what I did was I put it in the colander section. So you see all that gristle at the bottom? And I put it in for 6 minutes, and then I kind of just broke it up, moved it around so that the middle part was moved to the outside and the outside part was moved to the inside, because microwaves cooked from the outside in. So the middle part was more pink and the outside was more brown. And so after I stirred it up, I cooked it for another 6 minutes. And this is what it looks like after a total of 12 minutes of cooking in our stack cooker. And what I really wanted to show you was the amount of gristle that came out of this. Because a lot of people, a lot of you guys probably, use recipes that starts with a pound of ground beef. And so this is what I do to prep my ground beef for any dish. The only time I wouldn't do this is if I need to reserve hamburger for like hamburger patties or that kind of thing. But I'm going to point this into the stack cooker, and you're going to see all the fat and gristle that have come off. This is what came off of that meat. So if you're browning this in a pan, you're browning it in all of that stuff and cooking it in it versus cooking it this way in the colander, where as it cooks, it's dripping away. So you can see some of that yuckiness at the bottom of the stack of the colander. So because when you're doing it this way, you can't really break it up while you're cooking it. Kale, I'm browning my ground beef for my, Angela shared a Big Mac salad on her page yesterday, and I want to make that because I miss eating Big Macs. So right now I'm just prepping it. I'm not actually making a meal. So I'm prepping my ground beef. So because you're cooking it this way, you can't break it up while it's cooking like you would on a stovetop. So what I do is I take the cooked meat and I put it in my Power Chef and I chop it up using the Power Chef. So you can use this to mince it up as fine as you want. If you wanted to make like taco meat, you know, like that. Yeah, so like literally it was like a Big Mac without the bread. And so I was thinking about it when I saw her post, because I'm like, in a Big Mac, what's in there? It's like garlic, onion, hamburger patty, lettuce, pickles, and Thousand Island dressing. So her recipe had the ingredients to make the dressing, but I have a class tonight at the gym. So I just wanted to make it super fast. So I just bought Thousand Island dressing, and I did check. It has 4 grams of carbs per 2 tablespoons or something like that. So I just have to limit the amount that I'm using. Hi, Brittany. Hi, Teresa. So there's my beef. So now I can either wash this by hand or put it in the dishwasher. And I'm going to try and grind this up. Now, I'm a little concerned because my motor is pretty weak. I use my Power Chef a lot. And if I overload it, a lot of times it'll like unhinge itself. So let's do this. We're gonna rock it first. There we go. Oh, see, I knew. Hi, Alexis. I you know what? According to the scale, I've only lost about 20 pounds, but I feel like I've lost more. So let's hope that this motor works with me, because this is kind of a lot of meat in here. I don't think this motor is gonna work with me. I have to go get a new one. And I don't know where I put them all. They're like scattered all over my kitchen, because sometimes they fall off the shelf and stuff. Of course, this is going to happen to me right now while I'm live, you know. The other fix is to take out some of the meat, which I really don't want to do. It's really stuck. I think I'm going to have to. For now, anyway. We'll do this in sections. I might as well do it in sections, because I'm not going to use all of this meat for dinner tonight. I'm only going to use half of it to make the salads. I'm not going to do all. I'm going to save some of this for dinner for another night that needs browned ground beef. Hi, Marianne. Hi, Kelly. Hey, Sean. I'm just browning some ground beef in this 500,000 degree weather. So let's do half. And hopefully the motor is going to be a little more manageable. Another thing that happens, just so you guys know, this is hot. And so when this thing is hot, the plastic expands. So it's more tighter when you put the pieces on and stuff. So don't feel like it's broken. There. Just gotta go easy on it. Okay. So this is the meat that I'm gonna use for the salad. So I want it nicely, finely minced. Muscle is more than fat. That's what you meant to say. I agree. So tonight, for those of you, hi Jane. Hi, Angela. There she is. She's the one that shared her recipe, and this is what I'm going to make later on for dinner. Hi, Christine. Like I said, it expands, so it gets tight. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put this on the side. I'm going to cook this again later on tonight in the stack cooker, but with the onions and the garlic, because I don't like to eat raw. I don't really care for raw onions and garlic. So this, freeze it, holds about a pound of meat, and this meat is still kind of warm, so I'm not going to throw it in the freezer. This one is not, but I wouldn't put this in the freezer when the meat is still hot. Oh, perfect. So this is about a pound. Yay. So that's why I like these freeze-its, this particular size, because it helps me gauge like how much meat and stuff we're using. So a pound of brown ground beef. This is going to go back into the stack cooker later. I just wanted to prep it now because I have all of this meat that I need to brown up. So rather than do it in sections, I did all of it. And this is also a great way if you run into this problem, because I do all the time. If your meat is about to turn. So like maybe you defrosted it and it was a huge batch you thought out and you meant to use it, and it's like, oh my gosh, I better hurry up and use it because it's about to spoil. Brown it in your stack cooker like with this, and then freeze it. Then you've just extended your amount of time that you can use your meat rather than throw it away. I don't know about you, but I hate when I have to throw food away. It's painful with the cost of living and cost of everything now. It's just painful to have to throw anything in the trash, you know? Hi, Kelly. Hi, Anna. Yeah. So speaking of fat and fat weighing more, muscles weighing more than fat, my friend Kelly there, she's a hammer. She's like a major gym rat. I used to be a gym rat. I used to go to the gym twice a day. Twice, sometimes three times a day. I don't do that anymore, but I'm going to. I went to the gym this morning. Believe it or not, I actually ran on the treadmill. I only did 16 minutes. I told myself 1 mile today and that's it, because I do miles. Yeah, Kelly, come on. You're the squatter. I forgot, you used to wear those clothes that says like if squat, real girl squat or whatever. So I'm not a runner. Running is something I hate doing. But I told myself I have to do what I don't want to do if I want to get different results, right? So if I, you know, running, the reason I hate running is, number one, I have big boobs. So running is painful if I'm not wearing the right bra. And because I'm heavier than I was 20 years ago, running is not a comfortable thing for me where everything is jumping, bouncing all around, flopping, you know. I remember when I was like in high school, I used to rollerblade 2 miles every day. Humidity is mental, Michelle. Hi, Itzel. So I told myself I'm going to do at least 1 mile, however long that's going to take me. And there's this particular treadmill at the gym that I've never seen before, and I love it. So it's not like your, that's the one, lift like a beast, squat like a boss. It's the thing is not like your typical treadmill. It looks like rubber treads, like a tire tread. And it's softer on your feet when you're actually running. And you can actually pull a magnet thing off and it unlocks the, what do you call that thing? The conveyor belt thingy. And so you can actually, just hold on to the handles and run at your own pace. You can't do it without holding, so that's the reason I don't do it, because when I run, I like to use my upper body too. But you hold on to the thing and you can push back, like almost like a scooter. And so you can run that way. The baby's saying, uh-oh. She threw her bowl over the gate. So I use that one and I love it. And the incline goes up to 15. So this is what I do, because running is my not so favorite thing. I start with like a speed walk. And usually I do like a 3.5 speed. That's the speed I go on. Then when I start feeling myself get warmed up. Oh, so it was 2 pounds of ground beef. Perfect. When I feel my body get warmed up, I will increase the incline to 3. So it's 3.5 speed, 3 incline. It adds a lot more to like getting your heart rate up. And then I slowly increase, and I go all the way to 15, which is the max incline. I don't know what degree it is, but it really gets your heart pumping. And then once I just kind of go up and down. I don't leave it on one setting. And then what I do is when I get it back down flat, I won't run on an incline, but when I get it back down flat, that's when I'll pump it up to like 5 or 6, because that's like the fastest I'm going to run. I'm not running faster than that speed number, that number that's on the machine. And so I'll run for a minute, because I'm not a runner and I'm not going to kill myself to do this. RJ was doing it for like, I think a quarter mile, and then he got off and did burpees, and then he did a quarter mile because he was next to me. I was like, brada, no. So I did 1 minute of running, and then I would slow down and speed walk and get my heart rate back in check. And then I would do it again. And I was doing that back and forth for the whole mile, because I figure if I can just do 1 mile, that's 1 mile I did, because I normally walk 2 miles outside. The reason I don't like to do it is because the sun, it's too hot. So that's what I did. Then I did a little leg work on the machines. I did want to do like arm work, but I'm glad I didn't, because on my way out, I was scheduling classes like to take. And so at 7 p.m., the coach that I signed up with is teaching the DUT class. So DUT is Daily Ultimate Training. It's basically a circuit training in a group setting. And when we signed up, I think there were 25 people in the class. And the reason I like this class is it changes it up. So you like they do that, you know, there are 3 or 4 rounds of whatever the workout is, and it's pretty intense, but it's not for a long duration of time. You just do it for this many minutes and then you take a quick break and then you do it again. And so it's a 50-minute class. So RJ signed up with me, so we're gonna do that tonight. I'm gonna take another class just like that at 8 o'clock with a different coach on Saturday. And the kickoff to this breast cancer challenge thing is at 10 o'clock. So right after. So I'll be at the gym like all morning on Saturday. And then Sunday at 11 o'clock, I'm doing it again. You know what, Michelle? I used to work out like this crazy kind about 10 years ago, because I wanted to get in shape and get myself back together again. And then I got pregnant. And then I got pregnant again. So the last time I was very, very slim was right before I had Emily. And then right after I had Emily, because this gym opened up next to by my work, and then everything just went all to the crapper. So now we're gonna get back into it, and I'm getting closer to 50, guys. Like, I either gotta do something now and be proactive about it, or my body is gonna fail me before I'm at the age to be retired. So I have my lettuce already sliced up. This is 3 weeks, probably. I don't even know how old this lettuce is. It's been in my Fridge Smart, so now we use it all up. But it was very, very crunchy when I cut into it. So my Fridge Smart now has my bok choy. Oh, thank you, Wesley. Hi, Chrissy. So I've been soaking this in water. And I'm going to spin this dry, because this is going to be our salad. And then later on this afternoon, I'm just prepping everything because I want to break it up into sections. I don't want to kill myself later this afternoon. It is really hot. So I figure if I'm going to do this, I may as well like start prepping stuff. And then later on, we'll finish cooking up the meat with the onion and garlic and throw everything together. The hardest part is committing to saying I'm going to do it and actually doing it. Like, we all know what we gotta do to lose weight and get healthier. It's just, once you put it in the universe, like, cool, I'm gonna do it. Like, yes, I'm gonna accept RJ's challenge, putting that challenge on me. I was like, I really don't wanna do it. But I'm glad I did, because I really need to start putting me first, you know. So I'm going to put this in this vertical fridge smart just to keep it cold and crispy. And the reason I'm using the vertical, oh, there's like a little lump here. I'm using this because this is what fits in my refrigerator right now. Because I have, the two extra larges in there with a couple, another like a medium deep and stuff. Oh my gosh, this all fit in here. Perfect. This is the vertical one. I love this size. Sometimes tall and skinny fits better than short and big, yeah. You can do it, girl. Kelly, you was jacked before. We're gonna, pretty soon we'll be hitting 50. So two heads of romaine sliced up and cleaned. So now this is gonna go in here. Oh my God, of course it's too tall to fit over there. So there, there's my two extra large. So now the bok choy is in here. It used to be the lettuce. And I still have the spinach, which is the same, probably age, the same age as the lettuce. I'm gonna cream that one. So I'm gonna cream up the spinach later. Okay, so there's that part. I'm gonna come back later on to finish up the beef and season it for the Big Mac salad. I'm gonna let this cool off before I put the covers on. So that was 2 pounds of ground beef that I did in the stack cooker for a total of 12 minutes. Cut it up in the Power Chef and we're all good to go. My favorite healthy meal, believe it or not, because you know we're doing keto, yeah, low carb, low sugar. My favorite meal would have to be, gosh, that's a hard one. I was thinking more of a snack. You know, let me see. What do I like to eat? I would have to say a steak and eggs. That's probably my favorite. That's my favorite go-to meal anyways, is steak and eggs, especially after the gym, like after the morning workout and I'm starving, I'll have steak and eggs. But you know what I've been really craving a lot lately is pepperoni and cheese, not the bread or the tomato sauce. But like, so Wednesday, last night was church night and we have Baskin Robbins. That's our ritual. Once a week we get ice cream. And right now my favorite flavor is the pumpkin cheesecake one. So I got me a scoop of that. I ate like 1/3 of it, not even a half of it, and I couldn't do it anymore. I was like, oh man, like my body wasn't fiending for it. And so instead I put it away, and what I ended up eating was Swiss cheese. I know that sounds so weird, but I ate Swiss cheese. And so when I just came back from Walmart, because I was picking up some ingredients for the dressing for the salad for tonight, and I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna get Thousand Island. I'm just gonna do it that way. But I was craving pepperoni and cheese. You know what, I tried this cheese. Have you guys ever tried Havarti? Is that how you even say it? This is really good cheese. I've never tried it. I only bought it because it was on sale. You can't do keto. Oh, when you lift you need carbs. Hi Heather. Good carbs. Where is it, people? Okay, so this is what I bought because I had a craving for meat, believe it or not. I love pepperoni because we're doing low carb, right? And you gotta have your fat intake too. I'm gonna try this turkey pepperoni. It says 70% less fat, zero carbs. But I never saw turkey pepperoni before. Oh my God, Havarti cheese is onolish. And I got me some salami. I don't know if I like salami that much, but it was there. 1 gram of carbs per 5 slices. Why does salami have, oh, because it has wine in it. I didn't know that salami has wine in it. Okay, I'm going to try this turkey one while this is cooling off. Since we're talking starry anyways. Even if you're in ketosis, like your body burns fat instead of carbs for energy. Let's try this turkey one. Not bad. Hi, Lisa. How's your car, girl? I would totally... There's a spice to it. I like it. This one's a winner. I think I'm gonna buy the turkey one instead of the regular one from now on. Wow, look at this. The regular pepperoni has 14 grams of fat, The turkey one has 4. What a drastic difference, y'all. 1.5 is saturated. Wow. I'm totally gonna do turkey from now on. Aw, I'm so sorry to hear that. Nicole, I lost, according to the scale, I'm still at 20, but my body feels like a lot more. You know what else, guys? I still have 2 loads of laundry. One is in the dryer, one is in the washer. I gotta do that too, and I have to pick up Emily in an hour. Oh my gosh. And then I have to process, I have a new recruit. Yay! You smell it? It smells peppery. This is good. Really good. Yeah. Kristen, the turkey one is not as greasy, you're right. Kelly, we're doing keto and we're surviving. You just have to just say no. And if you do indulge in that stuff, I cut everything in half. Like half a manapua. I think my biggest weakness is fried noodles. And poor cash. Not so much manapua, because I would have to be craving for manapua because of all the bread. But poor cash. From Libby's or IA manapua shop. Oh, for days. I could eat that for days. Okay, this is yummy. I still haven't had lunch. And that's probably why I'm hungry. So I think I'm going to have myself some meat and cheese. I'm going to not do freaking protein drinks because that thing ripped my butthole the last time I drank that. And I think, hi Leanne, the client, I think protein shakes have a lot of carbs in it, doesn't it? Ramel just bought stuff. Let me look what he bought. I forgot that I transfer all of his supplements to modular mates, so I can't, there's nothing on there. I'm gonna have to Google it. But yeah, see, now I'm starting to calm down. Me too. I wish rice wasn't a carb, even brown rice. Thank you, Lisa. It's a lot easier to manage, especially in the gym. Like, that's like, I can just put this all up. And last night, my mother-in-law actually said, "You're really losing a lot of weight." So I take that as a very, very big compliment. Because I don't know how many... It's cooled down already. I don't know how many of you guys, your mother-in-laws, compliment you. Normally, she tells me I'm getting fat. So when she tells me I'm losing weight, I must really be losing weight. So let's put this up here. Everything's in Tupperware. Oh, I still have cabbage. So I have Brussels sprouts, I got cabbage, spinach, lettuce, and broccoli. I gotta make sure we have enough. Okay, so I'm gonna come back on in about 3 hours or so with the rest of dinner. This was just the food, the meat prepping part and all that stuff. And then later on, I'm gonna throw everything together. I'm also gonna print out her recipe because I didn't print it out. But I'll see you guys later on. Thanks for joining me during your lunch break. Lunch break is now over. Okay, I'll see you guys later. Bye, everybody.